Hello, it's the 10th of December. Little weekend in the cottage. Let me get that fire going in a bit. Hang on. That'll tilt. I should have some coal in there soon. Daylight's fading already, but it's not bad out. A bit dull. Come have a look. Oh, there we go. A few swans having a swim about. Pleasure boat and the pub across the road. It's always handy having a pub across the road, isn't it? Nothing coming through at the moment, no narrow boats coming through the lock, so that's it. I see a few people in there. Boats have got the fires going. I can smell the coal burning. Hello, Swan. Yes, I know. You're right. There we are. There's a few people walking, but that's about it. Well, it's a bit chilly. In a bit. Hello, it's 5 o'clock. Had a little snooze and done a very important job. Got the fire going. Let's see, that's better. That's got a good draw on it, so it'll be cosy later. An Antiques Roadshow on the telly. What more could you want? I know, pub. There's the pub over there. Just left the cottage. Pub time, Christmas lights are up. I don't know if you can see, but there's a couple of swans there having a nap right by the lock. You having a tip, are you? That's handy because right next door, just clean this lens. I think I've got a dirty lens. That's better, the fog's gone. Right next door to the cottage is an Indian restaurant. Works out well. Oh, look at those nice Christmas lights on the clock. That lovely. See them? Yeah. Lovely. Like a lot of water flowing through the lock there. No one. And here's the. Here's the pub. See you inside. That's dinner out of the way. Not much left out of that lot. Feel better now. Might go for a wander up the canal in a bit or not. See how it goes. Right, glass of wine, change, and a good old Margaret Rutherford, Miss Marple film. Can't beat a bit of Margaret Rutherford. Morning. Saturday the 10th of December 2016. Morning. Ooh, grumpy. And well, it's drizzly. Just had a shower. Had a great night last night in front of that old fire watching telly. It's brilliant. The old Miss Marple films. I think it might be like this for the day. It looks a bit drizzly. It looks one of those. Never mind. I don't think many people are out and about doing much today. We'll go off in a minute and have some breakfast, I think. There's a very good cafe up the road called Super Sausage. It's on the A5 towards Milton Keynes. And it's brilliant, so I feel a sausage sandwich coming on. Okay, I'll keep you up to date what's happening today, so thanks for coming along. See you later. Here we are. Super Sausage. It's breakfast time. That was Super Sausage. Regional winner, best calf in England 2016. And for anyone watching, or Top Gear fans out there, you may remember that the three lads actually went there one time for breakfast. So if it's good enough for Top Gear, it's good enough for anyone. It's really grey. Look at that. Anyway, I think we're going to have a stroll around somewhere else in a minute. So see you shortly. Come along. Feel free. Even though it's miserable. Bread. Chips. Not necessarily in that. This is like an artisan-y market thing. Tea room. Beauty studio. Don't need that, do I? How nice. And a toilet. Shame it's not sunny. US Upton Smokery. There's a smokery where they smoke things like meat, I suppose. Oh, look. Mulled cider. I know where I'm going in. More dynamic goings on, shopping in Waitrose. There's a lot of cars about. Santa on his boat. For the kids. Must be the Santa Cruz special. Santa Cruz. Brilliant. Ho ho ho. just nibbled over to the pub. There's a Christmas fair thing on, so we might have to have a drink while we're there. And there goes Santa Claus and his elves on the narrowboat with its blue lights on. There's the old lock. That's what we can hear from the cottage all night. It's the water flow, it's quite nice. Where are you going? Oh, it's that pub. Ah. Brilliant though. But the wrong pub. The navigation we're going to. Oh yeah, Christmas market. Strangely enough, we've ended up in a pub again. How can that be? Saturday. 4:30, dark. We were going to eat up there in the restaurant, but it's looking very... like they put the lights out for whatever reason. So, it's always the Indian. Don't mind an Indian. A little wander up here. It's very misty. That's the Stoke Brewin Canal Museum. You can see in there, but they've got like canally museumy things they sell. We go right up to the end. There's the Blisworth Tunnel, which is a very, very long canal tunnel. But I don't think I will because it's drizzling. There's a good old engine, look at that. Bolinder's crude oil engine. Yeah, it's a boat engine, but it's in good nick. I wonder if it would run, I suppose it would if you renovated it. Fred Dibner would have got that going, no problem. Have a wander up here. Have a little wander. I think I can hear a boat coming. Oh yes, they've got their Christmas lights on. Very nice. Hopefully you can see it. A little bit of daylight. That looks very cosy. Look at that. Indian chief. Lovely. And their dinner there. That looks very cosy. That's the Santa special coming back. Isn't that lovely? That's the last Santa special going by, I think. Everybody's ensconced in their boats now. It's been a real dank old day, a very damp sort of December day really. On the upside it's warm. Personally I prefer it crisp and cold, but there you go, can't have everything. Yeah, I was saying earlier, the Blisworth Tunnel. About half a mile further, not even that, quarter of a mile further up here. So, been through it once. You can still see the marks of where the people used to push the boats through using their feet. Quite interesting. Oh, is there? A tea boat. It's a good idea. Oh, tilt. Then, oh, we've got the old Christmas lights on, isn't that nice? There's a tea boat open if you fancy a cup of tea. Afternoon.
Hiya.
Hiya. Sit in, takeaway, homemade cake. Wraps, drinks, dog friendly. Is that dog friendly wraps? It looks very cosy. Look at that. I love the smell of coal burning. It's starting to get a bit drizzlier now, so I actually think I might just turn round and head back to the cottage. Cool, that's not smokeless fuel on that old thing, is it? Lovely smell though. There's me thinking it's fog. It's not fog, it's smoke. They've all got the older, got the old fires on now, starting to get chilly. Probably can't see it, but there's one in front of us as well, so I think on that note I shall turn around and head back and catch you all in a bit. Hope you enjoyed the little walk. Glad you came along. I'll catch you later. Well, it's a great shame, but discovered this today. It's very nice. I'll show you what it is. I think salted caramel Wharf Distillery vodka. Salted caramel vodka. It's very nice. Well, that's it. Home tomorrow. We've still got an Indian to look forward to, and I think we're going to come back and watch another Miss Marple, Murder Ahoy. Good old Margaret Rutherford. I don't know if you can see out there, but it's I think it's raining again. I think so. Yeah, it's raining. Never mind. Whack a bit more coal on the old fire. And that'll keep us going for a bit, so. See you after the Indian. Or if I don't, I'll see you in the morning. Either way. Catch you later. Bye night. Just a quick update. I was right, by the way. Tipping down. This lens has gone dirty again. Well, it's better. It's a good job the Indian's next door. Shan't be getting wet. That's it. Food. Said I'd get back to you. Just had a starter. Not much left, but that wasn't it. Main course coming. Very nice, isn't it? Look at that. Lovely. Very nice. See you after the food. One picture's worth 1,000 words.
Judicious.
No, no, we're stuck at the back.
How long are you?
63. Right, where can we turn?
Morning. Sunday morning, about 8 o'clock. And look at what a lovely day it is. Beautiful. She's got a blue sky. So I thought I'd take us to the end of the tunnel. Now I know I did this walk last night and it was different, it was dark and the lights were on, but if you're going to find the walk along the towpath a bit boring, then you've got that old fast forward button. If you don't want to fast forward it, come along then. Come along, see what's going on. Some smoke ahead, somebody's got the old fire going already. Really is nice. Look at that. 21st century narrowboat. Got a satellite dish on it. Got a plant pot behind it, I suppose. Oh yeah, all the old fires are going now, look. Ah, lovely smell again. That was a wood burner, that one, I think. What a cracking morning. Squeaky shoe. Morning. Right. Lovely, thank you. I've been on a narrow boat, the old coal fire going, and that's lovely and cosy. Takes a while to warm up though, so. My retirement plan many years ago was to live on a narrowboat, so I looked into it. It's not something to be taken up lightly. It all sounds very idyllic, but as anybody out there who lives or has lived on a narrowboat will tell you, there's a lot of hard work involved. You're a bit like a snail. You've got to carry everything with you. You know, you don't just flush a loo and it disappears, or turn a tap and the water comes on, or you know, light the fire or turn the central heating on. you've got to go and fetch your coal, you've got to fetch your water, or your fuel, or whatever you're using, and any waste products, you know what I mean, you've got to get rid of. So, yeah, it's the sort of life you'll love or you hate, I suppose. It's irrelevant now, because I found my lovely wife and got married. But perhaps when we retire, never know. Just look at these leaves, aren't they lovely? Brilliant. I love this time of year, especially a day like this. It's like one of Scudo Campers walk through the leaf videos. One of my favourite channels. There's three great channels I really love looking at. Scudo Camper, Rick Van Man, of course, who was my original, I think it was my first subscription. And Wiltshire Man, if you ever get a chance, look at their channels, they're brilliant. They kind of do some really interesting things, take you along with them, and love watching them. I woke up this morning about 2 o'clock, and I was lying there, and I could hear, I think it was a fox or a deer, I always get them confused, barking away. There was the rush of the water, the wind was howling around like an old horror film, and then an owl started up. It was brilliant, just lying there listening to them all. And I just lay there for a while thinking, nature's bloody brilliant, isn't it? It really is. I feel so sorry for people who just live in towns and never get out of them. I don't know why, they probably feel sorry for people who live in the country. Here we are, it's coming up, look. Elizabeth Tunnel. Oh, excuse me. There's a blacksmith workshop here as well. That's something really interesting as well. You watch the old smithies working away. Very, very clever, very skillful. Elizabeth Tunnel. It's 3,075 yards long, or that's 2,812 metres. Two-way traffic. Oh, I never thought that. I thought it was one-way. Yeah. Takes about 45 minutes to go through. Yeah. It was opened in 1805. Oh yeah, wide enough for two narrow boats to pass. Brilliant, marvellous bit of engineering, look at that. I don't know if you can see. It's actually a very early picture of it. Sound like something's coming through it. Business, by the way, is in Northamptonshire, in England. Lovely little place. There's the old blacksmiths. And I'm sure I can hear something coming through the tunnel. That's quite interesting. That's one of the concrete rings, I think, that they actually constructed it with. Yeah, it's a section of the tunnel. Well, a section of the rebuilt tunnel. Obviously, it was rebuilt. They didn't use concrete originally. And, should be able to see her. You can see in there. I can't quite see. See a light. There's definitely something coming. Probably a bit closer up there, a bit further away. Marvellous construction. I'll wait a while and see if this narrowboat comes into view. You'll notice along there, that used to be sort of a path going up to the top of the bridge, and behind here is what they've turned into a woodland walk. But you can see basically if you look up there where the walk is, that's another path that goes up to the top of the bridge. Then they go along the bridge and down the other side, very much like this. The reason being, early boats didn't have engines, they were pulled by horses. Because you've got to remember, in those days they weren't pleasure boats, they were cargo carriers. Actually, that explains why you can get two boats through the tunnel. Of course, they had a thing called a butty boat, and that was a non-powered boat tied to the powered boat to the side of it. Obviously, you could carry twice as much and get twice as much money. Anyway, I'll diverse. Horses, yes. So what they do was, the horses would tow the barge up to the tunnel. Excuse me. And then, of course, the horses have still got to get over the top. So the horses would go up the side. The narrow boat would be pushed by foot. Two chaps would lie on the top. I'm sure there's videos of it on YouTube. And they'd basically use their feet to walk it to the other side of the tunnel, where the horses hopefully were waiting. And off they'd go on their merry way and take their china or coal or wood or whatever up to probably Birmingham or somewhere. Anyway, no sign of a boat coming. I think the engine I heard was something going that way, not this way, so never mind. Anyway, there you go, Bisworth Tunnel. Sunday morning. Poor chap up there's got a 63-foot boat, and they're very hard to turn around, and that's the only turnaround point here, so he's having fun turning that. As you can hear, Sunday, we're all being called to church. I'm going to nip back, have a bit of breakfast, and get that old fire going. It's a bit nippy, even though it looks like nice and warm. It's a bit chilly, so anyway, that was me weekend, and thanks for joining me. Hope it wasn't boring. Thankfully, you've got an off button and a fast forward, so if you've stuck with me all the way through, thanks very much. I'll see you all before Christmas, so don't panic, and have a good week ahead. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye now. Morning.
Kindly.
Oh, it's got to be done.